The gentleman from California, Mr. Cárdenas.
Thank you very much. Madam Speaker, my colleague, Congressman Bowman, thank you for reserving the time on the floor of the House of Representatives so that we can speak the truth about what too many families, too many people, mostly poor people, have to endure, not only in America, but around the world. I was born and raised in the Northeast San Fernando Valley, and I'm very, very proud to say in the Senate, I have a colleague who grew up in Pacoima just like me. His parents, immigrants from Mexico, so are mine. We went to the same elementary school, the same high school, but yet at the same time, we ended up being on the city council together for some years. Him as a council president and me as a new member, he said to me, Tony, what committee do you want to chair? And I said, I want to chair the committee that oversees the airport, the ports, and the Department of Water and Power. At that time, the Department of Water and Power was the largest water and power district in America. Why did I want to be on those committees? Because those three entities are spewing the most into our atmosphere than any other organizations in Los Angeles. And it gave me the opportunity to live my values, to be able to grow up in a poor community. Yes, in the hood, in the Northeast San Fernando Valley, on that side of town, where there are more dump sites on that part of LA County, a county of 10 million people. But they've concentrated more dump sites in my backyard than any other place in that county. And Alex Padilla and I and our families, we had to endure that for generations. But here Alex is, a city council member, the president of the council, choosing to put me as the chairman of that committee. And on that committee, I forced the Department of Water and Power to finally clean up their act. Believe it or not, progressive Los Angeles, the Department of Water and Power that belongs to the city of Los Angeles, the people of Los Angeles. We were fooled in believing that we're a progressive community and that we would not be spewing out dirty fossil fuels to create the electricity that we depend on every day. But we did, ladies and gentlemen. Approximately 60% of all of the energy that was being produced for our city, for our community, was coming from fossil fuels. And under the presidency of the President Alex Padilla, who's now our United States Senator for California, and when he gave me the mantle of being the chairman of that committee, we forced the Department of Water and Power to cut their emissions in half, to literally divest themselves of dirty coal plants, to finally clean up our act. I'm very, very proud to say that as the council member, the first council member to represent that community to be born and raised in Pacoima, I was the first council member to tell a company that owned a private dump site when they wanted to expand it again and again and again. I was the first council member to say, no, you're not. And we denied them their expansion. The first time it ever happened. Again, ladies and gentlemen, for far too long, we were being represented by people who didn't realize or understand what it's like to grow up in a community where environmental injustice prevails and proliferates. And we suffer from asthma rates that other communities don't suffer. Our children do. Our families do. We suffer from groundwater that is more contaminated than any other places in America. We finally brought the grants from Washington, from City Hall, and from Sacramento, our state capital, to clean up our act, to clean up our groundwater. Those are the kinds of things that we're doing in Congress. Those are the kinds of things that the Green New Deal has brought to light, where before only certain people experienced it and only certain people cared. Now, today, we are talking about something that I'm very proud of. I'm very proud to be one of the original co-sponsors of the Green New Deal in this Congress, but equally proud with my colleague, Congressman Bowman, to be an original co-sponsor of the Green New Deal for Public Schools Act. These are the kinds of investments that we need to make as Congress. But equally important, we need to make sure that we continue to remind every single person that we are in this together. As goes our communities, as goes our country, as goes the environment, so does the planet. Even though some billionaires are flying up into the sky and getting into our space, this is our planet, ladies and gentlemen. We cannot escape it. And why try to escape it? Why don't we just look in the mirror and see what has been done and what is being done and to see what we all can do about it? That's the responsible thing to do. That's something that we can and should be proud of. So I stand here today to encourage every single one of us to help clean up our act. And to once again thank my colleague, Congressman Bowman, for inviting me and the rest of us to speak the truth on this floor today about how important it is that we have a Green New Deal for all. Thank you so much, and I yield back, Mr. Bowman.
Thank you so much, Mr. Cárdenas, for your passionate remarks.